Hello everyone, today I am going to show you how to use this plastic Beyblade to make a motorized one. So we need a plastic Beyblade, AAA batteries, 2 pieces, some tape and some tools with a motor. Any toy motor will work. So first we need to take the Beyblade, the plastic one, and remove the screw from the top using a screwdriver or anything which you are using to remove the screw. Okay, so after removing the screw, we'll remove that attack ring or anything which is in the middle. We'll remove that, which is like a ninja star. Okay, so we need the top and the bottom part only, not the middle one. And the screw, you can put it somewhere, we don't need that also. So we need to remove this tip from the bottom part. So we'll take a pliers and then pull it. See, it comes off. We have the bottom part now without the tip. So now we should cut off the middle one, and we should cut off the support, that 4 supports, to make a cavity so that we can attach the motor into it. We should cut the middle one. Now we have made a cavity, we have cut the middle one, and we have to drill the hole so that the tip of the motor could go through the Beyblade bottom part. Okay, so we'll use the other 2 side that pulls like something it is to support the motor. See, the tip comes out. If the tip doesn't come out, then you can make the cavity bigger. So now we should test it that it is working or not. I have a 9 volt battery here. So now I'll connect the both negative and positive terminals, and I'll see that the tip is moving when the tip is outside the Beyblade part or not. If it doesn't move, make the cavity bigger or position it nicely. So as you can hear, here are some, it is sounding like the motor is spinning. If you don't get it that the motor is spinning or not, you can touch and feel it. If it is rotating, then we can move on to the next step. So now we have to attach the motor something like this, and take your AAA batteries. We need 2 of them. So I'm going to remove these. Okay, so we have here our 2 AAA batteries. Now we have to do is, we have to take one battery and put each side of the motor. Make sure that one side negative and positive terminals are there, both sides, like this. And then connect one of each wire to one terminal. Okay, so first we have put some tape to support it. Now we'll put one wire to the negative terminal and one wire to the positive terminal. 2 on the one side only. The second side we'll just leave it like that. And the second side we have to put a switch there, connecting that positive and negative terminals. So now we have the switch and full connections. Now we'll put the top part on it so that it can support it. And it is easy to rotate it as well. Okay, so I have made one another. See, the switch is working very nicely. See, sound is coming, that motor is spinning nicely. Yes, I put some tape. Now test spin. Sometimes it don't work because the motor would stop, but if you have made it correctly, then the motor won't stop easily. You can use solder or anything to make it permanent. So this is how we do it. Thanks for watching.